Good morning, students. In the previous module, we had done some phrasal verbs where we had to match it with their meanings. We have already done these phrasal verbs and we know the meaning. Call off, cancel, come across, meet, make out, understand, put off, postpone, turn up, arrive, watch out, is to beware, and the last one, get away, is to escape. Already we have done this matching one exercise which is given in C5. Now children, in C6, what you have to do, those 7 phrasal verbs which I just read now, you have to use those phrasal verbs in the sentences given. Okay, so below they have given some sentences and those phrasal verbs, not the meanings, you have to use the phrasal verbs in these sentences, which is given in page number 57 of your workbook, English workbook. Okay, and the instruction given is fill in the blanks using the phrasal verbs of the previous exercise, those phrasal verbs which I just read. Now let us start with those phrasal verbs. You can do it yourself. It is a very easy exercise because meaning already you know. You just have to use them in the sentences. After doing the sentences, please check your answer with the video one. Number one, don't expect to dash with such a lame excuse. Now, what is lame excuse? Lame excuse means some silly things you are saying to get yourself. You are not have not done something and you want to get away from that work, and you are giving some very silly excuses, like people do not do the assignments and they say I was not at home, I had gone out, but when you come back you can do it. So bahana banana, and that also very silly things. So don't expect to get away. Get away we have done, the meaning is to escape. So don't expect. The asha means you don't expect that you will get away with such a lame excuse. Lame excuse means something very silly. Number two, so you write get away. Number two, the students could not make out what the instructor was saying. Instructor means the person who is giving some instruction, maybe some activity they are doing, and somebody is giving the instruction to do something, and the students were not able to follow, understand. So we have done understand means make out, understand. Make out meaning is understand. So the students were not able to make out what the instructor was saying. Coming to the third one, Mohan came across his classmate in the bazaar. You remember I gave you the example in the previous module that I came across my friend in the big bazaar. So similarly, Mohan came across means to meet someone. Okay, his classmate in the bazaar. Number four, thousands of people turned up to watch the final show. Maybe some event is taking place and many people, thousands of people have turned up. See children, I have written here in past tense. The phrasal verb given here is turn up, and I am used eating to make it past tense because already the people have gathered. Turn up means to gather. So turn up is gather to watch the final. We go for some music show or for dance event and we enjoy it. Number five, watch out for potholes. The road is bad. Now, what are potholes? Potholes are holes made in the road, like when you are going in a car or a bus, and especially during the monsoon season, you find your car and bus are bumpy, and because there are potholes, and if you fall on it, you will get the jerk. Or if you are walking on a road which is having potholes, your leg can go inside and you can get hurt, or you find disbalance yourself. So potholes are something that holds on the road. So watch out means beware. There is somebody, like I gave you an example, beware, there is a snake. Okay, so watch out for potholes. The road is very bad. Sixth one, children. Rain made the referee called off the the match again. I have written the past tense called up, already it's over. So because of the rain, the referee you all know, when you play the rain, somebody who manages the thing, referee called off the match because it was rain. Call off means cancel. Okay, so it was cancelled because it was raining, so match could not be. Done means you cannot. There was no match there because there was raining, so it has to be cancelled. And the last one, mother family or trip was put off. Put off means postponed for a time being. Mother is not well, so the trip which we had decided to go for it was postponed for the time being. Means we do it afterwards. So put off means postpone and call off means to cancel. So these are your auxiliary verbs in the sentences. I know you have already done it. You just check it. Don't expect to get away with such a lame excuse. Number two, the students could not make out what the instructor was saying. Number three, Mohan came across his classmate in the bazaar. Number four, thousands of people turned up to watch the final show. Number five, watch out for potholes. The road is very bad. Number six, rain made the referee call off. Oh, this children, this is OFF. Okay, be careful. It is not only one F. OFF. Off the match. And the last one, mother family or trip was put off. Again, OFF. Put off. Okay. So these are your phrasal verbs. Do it in your workbook. Thank you.